the Chovos Levavos that said, second paragraph, that although we're aware that nobody is aware the last moment of his existence, and we're aware that you have to be in a position to have sufficient merit to be worthy, and the physical sense, the person is going on a journey, affairs, whatever the provisions, whatever they may be. Ve'chnisalim, how could we turn a blind eye? Vanesim asmedus, the journey is continuous, meaning the eventuality of this journey, it's going to happen, just a question of when. Va'toka tidiro, and people being removed from existence is continuous. Va'derech oruch, and the road is a long road. Va'margor rochok, and the tranquility is far off. Why don't we pay attention to remember our end, meaning the objective? And we don't take into consideration the provision we need for our ultimate abode. We engage in the world which is temporary, which will come to an end. And we left and neglected what's permanent. And what do we address? The ailments of our physicality, of our bodies. But we forgot the diseases of our mind, our intellect, our understanding. And we serve the service of the evil of our inclination. And we've given up the service of our Maker, and we serve our desires. As we say, we're slaves of our desires. We don't serve our God. This confusion, how blind we are. And this level of intoxication, how strong it is. Their eyes are plastered over, that their hearts cannot comprehend. They become drunk, not with wine, no, they become unbalanced. Not from beer. Not from alcohol. No. They say, how many people walk a straight line? Lashisha Osir. No, we said this, we're behind. Where are we? What page? Okay. 7:22. First takes into consideration the length of time he's going to be in this world. Many people of his grouping have already made the trip. We're on 7:22, second paragraph. See, this is true. The person is older. His contemporaries are no longer here. So that person definitely, it should really resonate very loud and clear in his mind. You know, you're one of the lonely survivors. They're there. You have to be more serious about life. You have to take so many things into consideration. They've already made the trip to the other world before he did. When they were confident, and they had strong confidence that they would be associated with this world. But they all of a sudden, they got the notice check outside. And he did not take into consideration for his spirituality. He says he sees nothing superior in himself, deserving living longer than David. Yikatze tochalto ba'olam. He says this will cause him to limit his worldly aspirations. Yochalach miso. Remember many years ago, you should have. There were a number of students from South Africa in the 60s. And these boys, they would go home every 6 to 8 years, not like today, to visit the family. And one of them had to be there maybe about 6, 7 years. And he really was planning to eventually be married. And he already went to university. Work, and he gets a call that his father's having a festival. And he has to go back to Johannesburg to take over the business. He and his brother were in the United States, and his younger brother, he had a younger brother, and it's his responsibility. Never thought about this, not for a moment. Moment's notice, within 24 hours, he was traveling back. So whatever he had seen for himself in the United States, which he saw his future life here, turned upside down, and he traveled back until he eventually came back. It took about 20 years to come back to the United States. So what about all the planning, everything else? Everything was topsy-turvy. Everything was backwards. You plan, and you hope, and you this, and you think, and you have it all figured out. It's not so simple. Not so simple. It doesn't always work out the way you think it's going to. That happened, this type of thought entered my mind. Plan and this and that, all means nothing. Means nothing. So, regarding physical life, of course, you have to plan, you have to live responsibly. But in terms of, but he says, but it should be minimum, no less in you regarding your spirituality. You have to, what? You have to plan. You have to plan for the future. You speak about estate planning. Yes, estate planning. Okay? And need insurance. He should aspire for his end. And he has to take into consideration the provisions that he needs for the time that he will travel. And he has to make this calculation before the day of reckoning. All this has to be taken care of before the day of reckoning. Am I in a good position? You know, when they send you auditor, you know, the IRS, things better be in order. It's not all of a sudden you get the notice and then you start scrambling and you don't know what to do. That's how out of order things are. It's interesting. The Gemara tells us that the first person to become illness was Yaakov. Says, messenger came to Yosef, he made a lethal call. It's the first time in the Torah it's mentioned anybody being ill. Why? So the Gemara says that Yaakov was misbowed that illness should come into existence. So a person should be able to arrange his estate for his family, otherwise, there'll be total confusion after he passes away. So the Gemara says it's purely on a seemingly on a for financial reasons. But again, the person has no illness or whatever else, whoever thinks about dying, right? But already people, the person gets many notices, and a person has a sense of your vulnerability, and you don't feel invincible, then it brings certain things to mind. I mean, that's the value of illness. To be able to prepare for the eventuality of death, that's the reason why English, that he should be able to instruct his children whatever instructions he has to leave before he passes away. It shouldn't be something that comes upon him suddenly. This is Yaakov.